The IASB is consulting on a proposed update to the IFRS Accounting Taxonomy to help support high-quality digital financial statements. This consultation is important because we're proposing extensive changes to the IFRS Accounting Taxonomy. These changes reflect the presentation and disclosure requirements introduced by the newly issued IFRS 18. In this video, I want to focus on two specific changes. First, let's look at the change which responds to IFRS 18, requiring companies to present income and expenses in categories in the statement of profit or loss. We are proposing a line item modelling approach to reflect the category of an element in its element label. This approach is consistent with our general policy for modelling primary financial statements. This means companies will not need to invest additional time and effort adapting to a new approach. A line item modelling approach will also benefit users because it allows for XBRL calculations. These calculations make it easier for users to find and analyse the line item elements included in subtotals or totals. However, other approaches are possible, and we welcome any comments you may have on them. Now let's move on to the second change. IFRS 18 also requires management defined performance measures, or MPMs, to be included in financial statements. This means those measures are likely to be tagged for the first time. We are proposing a dimensional modelling approach to tag the MPM disclosures. This will allow preparers to detail tag their MPM reconciliations. Our approach will also allow users to extract and digitally consume information on MPMs. While I have focused on two specific changes in this video, the proposed update includes other changes too. We invite you to review the proposed update and provide your feedback on whether our proposals work well with the new requirements in IFRS 18. We welcome your comments by the 3rd of September 2024.